Okay, questions?
What was your reaction when you first heard word on Sunday? What was your first thought?
Well, you know, I had left church and I was going home, and to get the call, it was disturbing. I think any time you have any kind of issues like what we know is going on, any time you have discipline like this, or a kid's career basically is ended, you can take it very, very seriously. This is before we knew many of the facts. You know, at that time, all I really knew is he didn't miss curfew, and so I was very disappointed from that fact.
How do you think Coach Pitino's handled it?
I don't know how he could handle it much better. I think he was very, very swift. I think he handled it as quick as any human being possibly could do it. From my standpoint, you know, I know it was difficult for him because, you know, I think you always want to see all of your student athletes succeed. You know, there's a lot of people involved in this, and it's very painful for everybody. Obviously, we know there's no winners in this at all. But from a coach's standpoint, I'm very proud of how he's handled it. I think he's done a great job at dealing with it and dealing with it head on.
What is his mood like? Have you talked to him?
Oh, he's down. I mean, who wouldn't be? I mean, it's tough. This is a tough situation. It's tough for everybody involved, and it's tough for our university. It's tough for our community. It's tough for all the young people that were involved. I feel it. My heart goes out to everybody, and I just can't say that strong enough.
Have you talked to the other players on the team about this?
I haven't. Coaches dealing with that.
Mr. Jurek, is this an opportunity to address all student athletes here at U of L and let them know that allegations or behavior, whatever it turns out to be, like this, will not be tolerated?
I've been here 17 and a half years, so they've heard that speech from me many, many, many times. And they hear it from their coaches all the time. We have guest speakers all the time come in and talk about it. So I think it's something that has been addressed many times, numerous times.
You address it again?
Yeah, we will always address it. We will do it this year, that next year, this week. We'll continue to. It's a very, very top priority for us.
Was there any consideration last week about keeping him off the team with you making the suspension permanent?
For
Chris last week.
After the Syracuse game?
Yeah.
No, after the Syracuse game, our university, they handled their end of the disciplinary action of it. They had reinstated him. There was the complaint that was made by the young lady. She had asked for not to pursue it any further. We did our due diligence, looked at it. There was a lot more information that we had that is not public that we had to take into consideration. And we felt at the time it was appropriate for Chris to return, that he had suffered a strong enough penalty by missing that game at Syracuse.
How much of that decision is up to you versus the university?
Well, I think that's a pretty big team effort because, you know, certainly the university's in the middle of everything. We're in the middle of it. Coach Pitino's in the middle. He's with them every day. So I think it's everybody hand in hand.
Mr. Jurek, have you spoken to Chris?
I have not.
Will you?
I'm not sure if I will.
Do you know if Chris has tried to reach out to coach or vice versa?
I don't know that. You'd have to ask him. I don't know.
There was a question asked this morning at the U of L police press conference that they had. Somebody had asked if you thought that the suspension was adequate enough for a threatening text message like that. It sounds like you agree with the
original. Well, I agree that I thought coach did the right thing by suspending him. I think Chris felt bad that it had been sent. But again, there was a lot of circumstances surrounding that, Jeff, that never came public, that we had at our disposal. So we had to weigh everything, and I feel the coach handled it appropriately.
During his recruitment, were there red flags? Was there anything in Chris's background that you look back on now and think,
There really wasn't, Howie, and you keep hearing that thrown out. I mean, because he was a junior college guy, I can give you a lot of great junior college kids and a lot of great success stories of junior college kids. So I certainly don't want to paint a brush on him. This was the national junior college player of the year that everybody raved about, not only from his counselors to his coaches to his teammates, you know, from high school on up to junior college. So we have nothing in our background that we know of that he did wrong.
Who was your personal interaction with Chris?
I didn't have a lot with him. I would certainly say hello to him and that when I'd see him in the hallway and that, but never had a real close relationship with him.
Anything else?
There was Tom there. For people who actually listened to the radio interview and you were made aware of this, I think most of us understood what you meant, but there has been some confusion about you saying there was nothing major with the threatening text. text message. Do you want to clarify?
Well, first of all, I had never seen the text message, so I didn't know anything about that. What I was trying to say in that interview was, and I think it was the one you're talking about was with John Ramsey?
Correct.
Yeah, was it Coach has dealt with this kind of issue. We didn't know the magnitude of it, but he has dealt with these kind of issues and adversity many, many times. So I did not feel that it was going to be a big deal for Coach to deal with it. That's what I was trying to point out.
What's the process like for the university going forward? Do you go back and look at how we handled this and how we may handle it in the future? How do you handle it going forward?
Well, we always want to reexamine everything that you do. You know, I think the one thing that I'm most impressed of is how Coach dealt with this very, very swiftly. I don't think you could have done it any quicker than he did it and dealt with it without before he had all the facts. And that's a risk he takes, but he certainly understood it. He felt that he had given a lot of chances out, and I think the curfew was one that kind of pushed him over the edge. Now, there was other accusations, obviously, that have followed that now that we know about. I'm not sure Coach was privy to it. I do know that he knew that other things were to follow, but I think he at that time, he had enough.
Sensitive are schools now, a school like Louisville, in light of some recent events with NFL players and with professional players?
Well, I think you're always, Gary, I think you're always sensitive to it. I mean, let's be honest, I got two daughters, so they both played field hockey here. So it's a very sensitive spot for me, myself. But we've always taken it very, very seriously, and we'll continue to. At any school I've been in, whether it's Northern Arizona or Colorado State, I mean, we're going to make it a top priority. You know, luckily we have not had that many issues.
Has that kind of reinforced your zero tolerance policy in a sense?
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. We always will do that. I think that's a very difficult situation to remedy.
How concerned are you, rightly or wrongly, about how this can stain the reputation of the athletic department of the university? You know, nationally, when people hear this, you're obviously going to be associated with it.
Well, I don't think there's anything we can do about it. You know, we just got to keep doing the things that we've done. We've had a lot of great successes here, and you know, when we have these kind of issues come up, we got to deal with them. We deal with them head on. I always tell our people, you've heard me say it a million times, all of you in here, I always challenge people to look in the mirror. So where are you looking in the mirror now? And is there anything we could have done to prevent this? I'm not sure we could have, you know, but I want to make sure that we look at anything that might be a better assistance to us in the future to help it, but I just want everybody to know we're on high alert here at all times when it comes to domestic violence.
Is that when guys are, and obviously they come in a few seconds for people and have had some of that history or first coming here, how far up the chain does that get? Does that come to you?
Yeah, oh, absolutely. What we will do with every one of them, we'll handle it each one individually because each case is totally different. And we will look at it, do our due diligence. There's been a lot of kids, see, but you never hear about that, the ones that have succeeded here. And I've always forgiven kids extra chances. I believe in that because of their age. You know, I think they deserve that, you know, to a point. And so I want to make sure that we look at each case individually and see how that fits with each and every program because every coach is different. I would hope it would be okay. I haven't had a chance to speak with them. I think that would be a question maybe for Coach Pitino. But, you know, I think these are great young men. They're great ambassadors for the university. And, you know, I think they understand the magnitude of everything. I think these guys probably work with them as much as anybody. I don't think there's a bad apple in that group. So let's just hope we can keep them together and pull and go down to Tallahassee and pull out a great win.
Has there been much comment between the ACC and you guys yet regarding this?
No, there hasn't.
Is there a way that you could possibly keep tighter rein on athletes? I mean, I don't want to say restrict them, but how do you watch over them just to kind of watch their associations, just to, you know, kind of keep them out of trouble?
When you figure that one out, let me know. That's a tough one, Gary. I don't know how you could be any tighter and have more restrictions on our programs than we do already. You know, I think Coach Pitino, I think everybody knows that they seem to like to write about it, what a tight ship he does run. You know, so I think, you know, we're going to have issues at all times. They're still kids. They still have their own responsibilities. They still have to be accountable. They still have to look in the mirror every day. And that's the important thing that we want to teach here is you've got to look in the mirror. You've got to treat people with respect and kindness.
Anything else? Great, thank you. One thing just to clarify, when Jeff was asking that question about an interview,